Hello ladies and gents, I am Ladiffin and welcome back to From the Depths Adventure Mode. The first thing I'm going to do in this episode is I'm going to correct the shields which are the cause of the self-detonation on my ship. So as you can see here, the cannon at the rear here will fire and it'll go straight through this shield, which then reflects it and causes the inertial fuse to detonate the shell. And that is the cause of quite a lot of detonation, because it's not hitting the gun, it's hitting the shield and causing detonation nevertheless. So easiest way, just going to remove all the shields on these. I'm going to remove all of them though. Have I got colorizer in there? Yes, I do. So if you just remove all of these, probably leave this one on, to be perfectly honest. It won't be making that much difference, but then it won't actually be helping much either. That's that one done. Now let's do the other. Right then, now that will hopefully reduce the amount of self-detonation. Do need to do the rest of the shielding on this ship, since I have very little now. I've got some all the way up to the sides, but it's really only single layer. I would quite like triple layer shielding on this, but I don't think I have the patience. I may only use double layer shielding. The next thing I think I'm going to do and do is I am going to replace these guns at the side here with these big triple mounts. But in order for that, I am going to have to replace the hull. So let's just figure out whereabouts I would like them. And probably around about here. So that is around about 6 blocks in front of that. Okay, let's remove the guns and see where that takes us. The guns have now been removed, and unfortunately, just as an enemy spawned in. Fantastic. So I have a lot less weapon systems to deal with it. Oh well. That's fine. Lightning hood's design. Let's go find out what it is. Make sure I'm not holding any of the weapons. There's lightning hoods. Don't recognize you. A Tesla. Hydrofoil, part that's already damaged, hits some of the laser components, shooting most of them down, which is unfortunate. We'll just hit that ball turret. Excellent, it's now been sunk. Destabilizes the hydrofoils. A big weakness with hydrofoils and hovercraft in general, if you manage to hit them, it's quite easy to destabilize them, unless they are massively overcompensated like mine. EMP rack through there. The lambs are shooting most of them down, but with the great thing with frag is that if they are shot down beforehand, the fragmentation can still hit the target. And then if the main shell is hit, things die. Move my ship towards that, and probably towards that. There. Let's do like that. Don't need to go right next to it. And level up once more. I carry on replacing the gun mount. go. This is the location I'm going to be placing these turrets. Double check I'm actually placing it in the correct location though, on both sides. Yep. Oh, I've just realised I am wasting resources. See, my resources are full. I actually don't have enough resources to be doing all this. So, let's quickly put a load of these beams in place. I think this is the correct location for these beams. Let's just double check. So load a sub-object, triple turret, so probably up by one there. Oh, I can put a fair bit more on if I would so desire, which is always nice. Good location there as well, could probably fit another load of props in at back, which is perfect. Preliminary is working well. Just need to expand this down and make sure it all fits in nicely. And also remove all the current internals, which is a bit of a faff. Being attacked by something else again. It's intercepting a load of my shells. The twin guard, the fact that it's got two spawns next to each other. Oh no! Steel striders. Ah, a little torpedo plane. That's cool. Good timing. She has a particle cannon itself. That's worrisome. But I just hit it with the primary railgun and did a lot of damage. I'm a bit worried about what these shells are. What are they? Ah, pure HE. Cool. Not worried anymore. Excellent. Lasers did do consistent damage. Took out the little drone torpedo bomber at the rear. That'll allow them to finish up the main ship as well, which is currently sinking under the waves. Supercav guns are not very accurate. Excellent. Also too damaged. Okay, I do need to strip out some of my ammo cache in order to fit the new gun in position. That is affordable, I guess. But I can't now see, it's got too dark. So I'll struggle on in the dark, but it's not going to show out what I'm doing at the moment. Well, I've just realised I've been building this all slightly wrong. I kind of need to have this layer here, so the whole lot needs to be lowered by 2 blocks. Great. Oh well, off I go. All is building and building, and I've accidentally sunk my ship. Whoops. Where are I? Okay, I'm going straight down. Okay, this is a bit of an issue. It's because I've made it so heavy and also made a big hole in my ship. So let's sort this out as quickly as possible. So how I'm doing this, I'm actually just adding a load of props on. Why am I not going up? I'm getting... still going down. Ah, great. Going full force. Try and get up out of... well, the ground. This is what happens when you don't pay attention when you're building. And why I generally prefer building... if doing huge constructions, I do it in the main... in the designer mode, because yes, this happens in adventure mode. Fun times! Right, I'm gonna try and figure something out and be back once I am closer to the surface. Right, here we are, getting much closer to the surface. And here we go. It's my ship. Come on, come on. Get out of the water. Now I need to get these air engines in place of these standard jets, of the props. Go and do this, and that will stabilize me a little bit. So it looks like my ship is actually just about staying afloat. So my ship is almost out of the water. It is just that little bit too heavy. Let's plaster the thing with hydrofoils. Just adding more hydrofoils, just try and get a little bit more upthrust onto this thing. Still, it's that just a little bit too heavy. And there we go. My ship is now just above the water again. Only just. And now the rear is really heavy. It's a lot of heavy armor. And the fact that I have broken a load of the buoyancy seals. So nothing is buoyant anymore. Great. So while my ship tries to struggle onwards, let's go find out what I'm actually fighting. Ooh, looks like it's a Grey Talon's Rusted Ram again. Ship. Is that a Hunchback again? Is it Hunchback? Oh, an Onslaught. Okay, it's different. Good, hit that. Nice strike there. Some amazing aesthetics on this ship. The actual broadside arrangement of weapon systems. It's really pretty. Lasers seem just knocking out little bits of confetti, and then something really big hits, knocking off a ton. That. And here comes a heavy mortar. Oh, you've actually got warp drive! So that's the massive array of heavy mortar shots. We'll start bouncing off. They'll considerably reduce the life expectancy of you. Level up, good. So a lot of them are bouncing. They'd do well to have inertial fuses on, but the base bleeder gives them a considerably increased range and speed. Could very well be torpedoes. Weakness I now have. Good, the AI is dead to that. We're facing over here then. Dryder's design. Ah, and one of you. It's coming. Ooh, this time though I hit it right at the front. And where do I want you to be going? I really want to be going through one of the green portals, but I might not have much of a choice in the matter. Ha, red portal there. Let's go through that one. Okay, it looks like my ship is a little bit more stable now. So probably not going to sink immediately. Nevertheless, it's still very irritating. Ah, Heartstone blew up again. I'll just quickly, massively increase a temporary Heartstone. There we go. And this is sinking again. Goodness me, this is difficult to get going when you make it out of heavy armor. Heavy armor is heavy. It's in the name. Oh, the PID system went offline. Right, that's it. The Heartstone blew up to join the PIDs. Yeah, that would be why. And that noise is really irritating me. Seem to be having a massive struggle with my engine's not working properly, so I'm just wondering if my ACBs have broken something. So quickly go to an ACB, go to engines, fuel engines, and allow maximum to go all the way to full. So my engines aren't doing anything. And I don't know why. They're like pulsing on and off. But they aren't actually charging. Why isn't this actually responding? It's infuriating. Why? Well, I have reloaded and it seems to have stopped it all going weird. Something had broken on my ship and I don't know what, but with the amount of Heartstones I have on it, I am now working. But it's not looking particularly healthy at the moment. Does that mean I am leak free? Excellent, the buoyancy is sort of functioning. Probably because I've linked them together, and this one's probably taking precedence. There we go, at least have some buoyancy. Not fully there yet, but at least it's now partly buoyant, and I have at that semi-displacement, so no longer sinking! Fantastic! Oh, my ship has been fighting with another target for a moment. Oh, and it seems to have already disabled it. A smog. My big explosion racking through there. It seems like an earlier hit knocked off a load of sub-objects as well. Thanks, laser's not doing very well. Why am I not hitting it? Is detection weird? Ah, detection is absolutely atrocious on the target. That would explain it. Look at how patchy that detection is. Yikes. Suppose it's gone cold, so the IR detection's not working. Visual isn't doing very well, and where's the laser detection? Strange. Okay, I don't think I need all these heartstones anymore. What I will, I'm going to do though, I am going to move where the heartstone is. Since I can't be trusted to do this quickly by myself, let's change the speed down to slow. That will mean that I can now delete the heartstone while it's still draining. Quickly race through to where I want to be putting it. There. Mirror. There we go. Now that heartstone is massive. Don't need to worry about that breaking for a short while at the very least. Good. Right, what's shooting at me? So green lasers indicates it is a lightning hoods design and its smoke is activating continuous laser, so not generally too bad, but that is quite a big one. Hypatus. I have no idea how strong that actually is. I don't recognise the name, so it's probably an expert design. I don't know many of the expert designs. I mainly fight in testing against godly designs and like easy regular just to figure out what's going on. Oh, heavy mortar is now firing. So very slow loading there. Something must have just exploded. Okay, it looks like that the gun there, supercav gun, has been destroyed. Stripped off the outer layer of armor. Lost another gun. And another gun. Good grief. Hey, this isn't the end, is it? Please don't be the end. That's been terrible. The railgun's still working. But for how much longer? All the other weapon systems have been disabled. Okay, it is now disabled though. Completely gutted the internals there. Oh yeah. Let's go grab the resources though from that destroyed fleet and then this destroyed fleet. And level up again. Brilliant. Definitely deserve that. A good number of materials there. The 6,000 or so. There we go. I have just fitted in the actual heavy metal beams there to hold these guns in place. So I can actually place them on now. So, how much are they costing? 32k a pop. I can easily afford this. So, put those both on. Excellent. They're fully ejected, so they are basically safe. But I will armor this whole area up as well. Just because, well, I kind of should. Should just leave it completely open like this. So, let's just armor it all up like this. Here we go. I've at least armoured up the basics. Do need to add a little bit more armour around these, though. So I'll just finish up that up now. Just initial heavy armour around each part. Unfortunately, this is making my ship sink, because I've just made this massive heavy armour block at the rear of the ship. I've also forgotten to paint it as well, which is annoying, because, well, it's now completely unpainted. Need to repaint that all. But the whole ship is now sinking under the waves. Half the propellers aren't working. All that sort of stuff. So let's see if I can't get a little bit more propulsion out this thing. More hydrofoils, always very useful. At least help keep the midsection of the ship above water. It's just this rear section which is suffering severely. Let's actually try and put some hydrofoils straight on the side here. I'm just setting up the actual constraints now for the turrets. So I'll just copy this to clipboard, then move it over to the next gun and paste to clipboard. And then enable paste to clipboard. So that's all three firing pieces. Now I need to actually go to the turret block itself. Wherever you are. There we go, turret block itself. Edit that. And paste the limits on there as well. So that means it won't turn more, it'll turn between these two, giving a nice wide range of fire. I just need to work on the next gun. Right, I'm still trying to go through this portal. All the turret constraints have now been set on the new guns. So that makes this ship considerably more deadly. These are APHing, so they're primarily high explosive, but they have a high kinetic damage as well. And so the penetration fuse basically allows that kinetic energy to be expended on the target ship, hopefully breakthroughing a couple of beams, and then the shell will detonate internally, causing significant amounts of damage. Let's try and go between that. Let's go between that one, since I seem to be completely incapable of passing through that gate. Probably due to the mass of my ship at the moment. It's quite ridiculous. We're actually rocking and rolling now. I was kind of expecting it to be so heavy that that wouldn't be the case, but no, it seems to be a little bit unstable. I'm going to do much more in terms of expanding, since I have just put two colossal heavy armor mounts in, and also the guns to match. And I lost a lot of stuff to that previous battle, so I'm still repat. But, ooh. New target has appeared. All weapons are now... So the target is a Grey Talon's drone carrier with a lot of crams, a particle accelerator, and something is rather terrifying. And all those seem to be... Are these nukes? Yeah, that's a nuke. That's a nuke. Okay, it's got a load of nukes. Cool. Let's see how what happens then. The lasers should really be firing at the small things, but apparently not. Okay, it's actually just building more nukes. And here come the new barrage of shells. Oh, excellent. So high up that it fired its crams into space. They are going to be a threat to me. I do need better detection, though. So what's my detection like on this thing? Pretty poor. Oh, because it's just been shot in the back. Okay, that makes sense. Extremely slow, down to 5 frames per second. But it looks like there was a huge, huge explosion. It's because I've actually turned off degraded mode, and my game no longer goes into degraded mode, so it always looks pretty. Unfortunately, it does mean that it never runs fast. The continuous lambs on this is making it incredibly difficult to destroy, though I have neutered it by taking off all the barrels. Mainly just down to the primary railgun. The triples are not working so much, it seems. They aren't armed with frags, so I can actually see those quite a bit easier. The lasers, though, still doing a good amount of damage. Okay, there seems to be another enemy ship which is completely hammering me. It is the Devastation Twin Guard ship. That seems to be more of an issue. I'm just go through a portal, please. And if I do die, dying in this blaze of glory would be kind of awesome. But I want to save the ship. So I'll save it because I'm really quite liking the way this has turned out. It needs a massive aesthetic pass. Let me just bigs just exploding. Oh, I think there's a nuke. Okay, another ship's steel striders there. XFO-4. So that's you two damaged. Good. I've been in this area for far too long. Yeah, been here over an hour. Well, up to an hour now. I will have been in here over an hour. Primary railgun is really hampered. Look at all that damage there. That gun is disabled. That gun is disabled. All that's left are my lasers. I'm just currently shooting myself. Ooh, explosion! Okay, two of the ammo reserves. Let's take over manual control of the ship. Let's try and get out through this portal. Come on, turn, get out of here, you can't survive this current fight. And I missed the portal, okay. This is bad. This is very bad, since I don't think I have enough ship left to keep up the fight. It's not working well. Got an Annihilus over here. Unfortunately, the weather's so bad, I can't really tell what's going on outside of my vessel. That's just going to rip me apart. There's not much I can do about it at the moment. And I've lost another gun. Which one was that? That was... Oh, no, that... That was my heavy mortar. Yep, bits flying off ship there. Yeah, a hole through the center. Do I have any work? Do I have any operating weapon systems left? No. I don't. Shells tearing through there, taking EMP damage as well. I don't think my ship has any turning capabilities left. I think I'm sinking. The fuel has been destroyed. Come on, get me out. This isn't looking very good, is it? There's tiny little bits of salvage there. My enemies are now actually fighting each other. But I'm down to 78%. 78% on this thing is a ridiculous amount of damage taken. Since so much of it is now made, I've converted so much of it into heavy armor. At least I can sell load that heavy armor. Some resources there. Load of resources there. More there. There's resources all over the place if I could actually survive long enough to grab them. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to, because I don't have enough resources now to prepare myself. Unless I sell stuff. I can sell stuff. Something else considerable just fell off. Oh, that was my particle accelerator. Ball turret. Great. That's not going to be annoying in the slightest. So I think my failing is not setting up the multiple AI system, and that meant that my ship wasn't targeting the multiple targets efficiently. It was all firing at the same target, but at long range, whereas some of the other targets were higher priority. Also, I had been just massively just increasing everything to heavy armor because I had the resources to do so. I hadn't taken into account the increased mass that does, and this sort of thing, which occurs when you do that. And my ship has sunk. Oh, heck. Things are hitting it all over. What have we got? Oh, we've got Twin Guard torpedo ships. Move the other gun. Ah, torpedoes being hitting me. Let's just strip out some of this stuff. See if I can't make myself a little bit more buoyant. Refinery is about to explode. Great. Just try and get myself enough propulsion to get out the water. Explosion imminent on the refineries. I'm just sinking further and further down. Get rid of all these jet engines, since they're not doing anything apart from wasting fuel at the moment. Oh no. Clean out the water. upside down. Come on. Right then, my ship is back up on the surface, which is terrible because I'm out to get hammered completely by this vessel. Order. Which way am I going? Just try and get through a portal. I've been destroyed by this beautiful creation, though. Put a load of props on this side. I really want to try and turn quicker. Out of fuel again. Come on, get through there. And I'm safe for now. So that is a mess. Gonna leave the episode off for here. So thank you very much for watching this episode of From the Depths with myself, Anna Diffin. If you did enjoy the episode, please leave a like and or comment below, as it is always great to hear from you lot. Otherwise, that's it from me for now, and I shall see you next time, where hopefully I will be able to fix this up. But until then, I'm out. Goodbye.